chemistry classes. So today's topic is basic concepts part 3. So the last class, previous classes, we have learned some basic concepts like about neutrons, protons, electrons and laws of chemical combinations. In this class we are going to learn percentage composition and empirical formula, molecular formula calculations. So in this chapter we are going to learn percentage composition. The next campus is calculation of molecular formula. Calculation of molecular formula. Coming to the first point, percentage calculation, or we can say mass percentage calculation of an element. To calculate the percentage mass of an element in a given compound, first of all we should know the molecular weight of the compound, first point. And then what is the weight of a particular atom which you want to calculate the percentage of mass, we should know. So the first point we should know is mass of the compound. Mass of the compound. And the second one, what is the mass of element in that particular compound. So we can write a formula based on these two points. Percentage composition of an element. Or we can write mass percentage also. Mass percentage element is equal to mass of element by total mass of a compound. Total mass of compound into 100. Sample, for example, wanted to calculate percentage of C in CH4 molecule. So for mass percentage of C in CH4 is mass of C by molecular mass of CH4 into 100. So what is the mass of C? How many carbon atoms are there? Only one. Each carbon atom molecular mass is 1. So each carbon atom molecular mass is 12. So 1 into 12 by molecular mass of CH4. 12 plus 4, 16 into 100. So 12 by 16 into 100 is 4 3s are 4 4s are 4 25s are so total 75% of carbon is present in CH4 molecule. Like that we can take any example. To the molecular formula calculations, before going to start directly molecular formula, I would like to revise one point. That is, formula can be studied in three ways. That what are those means, I can revise. Formula can be studied. I will explain what is empirical formula and what is molecular formula. Let's write the point in empirical formula. Empirical formula is the one which indicates the simplest whole number ratio of all kinds of atoms present in a one molecule. So this we can define simplest whole number ratio of all kinds of atoms present in one molecule. This ratio of atoms of glucose is C1H2O. So this is the empirical formula for a glucose. That is the empirical formula for a glucose. Here you should remember one empirical formula could be an empirical formula for 2-3 molecules also. Means 2-3 molecules can have the same empirical formula. Example C2H2. What is the empirical formula is C ratio is 2:2, 1:1. So empirical formula is CH. For example, benzene C6H6. What is the ratio of carbon and hydrogen? 6:6. So again 1:1. So the empirical formula is again CH. So CH. From the empirical formula, we cannot guess the molecular formula unless we know the molecular weight. Molecular formula. It is the actual ratio of atoms present in a one molecule. Actual ratio. So means we cannot simplify the ratio of atoms in a molecular formula. For example, CH4. What is the actual ratio of carbon and hydrogen is 1:4. So CH4. So there is no chance to simplify the ratio. That's why each molecule is having only one molecular formula. It's a one molecular formula for a compound. But the thing is how to calculate a molecular formula if you know the empirical formula. So we have one relation that a molecular formula is equal to n into empirical formula. How to calculate n? N is equal to molecular formula weight by empirical formula weight. Molecular formula weight by empirical formula weight. If you calculate, if you know n, just multiply empirical formula by n, you will get molecular formula. Compound contains 4.07% of hydrogen, 24.27% of carbon, and 71.65% of chlorine has, and its molecular mass is given as 98.96 grams. Then what is the empirical formula and molecular formula? So first of all, we should get what is given and what we need to calculate. If you know these two things, 50% of problem has solved. So what is, first of all I write, what are the elements present in the given question? What are the elements present? Hydrogen is present and chlorine is present, carbon is present and chlorine is present. What is the percentage composition is given? Percentage composition. So percentage composition of hydrogen is 4.07 and carbon is 24.27 and chlorine is 71.65%. Convert these are the percentages, not the number of moles or weights of the compounds or atoms. So convert mole ratio of atoms. What is the mole ratio? So what is the atomic weight of hydrogen is 1.00. So 4.07 by 1.008, it is around 4.04. 24.27. So getting the moles ratio, convert the moles ratio into simplest atomic ratio. So what is the simplest ratio? Simple ratio. So what is the least value among these three values is 2.02 is the least value. Divide each number by 2.02. So then you will get 4.04 by 2.02, it's 2, and 2.02 by 2.02 is 1, 2.02 by 2.02 is 1. So what is the ratio of elements? Hydrogen is 2, carbon is 1, chlorine is 1. Right? So hydrogen to carbon to chlorine ratio is 2:1:2. Formula is we have molecular formula is equal to n into empirical formula. And how we can calculate n molecular formula weight by empirical formula weight. So molecular formula weight is given as 98.96 Cl2Cl we can write CH2Cl. So that is 12 plus 1 plus chlorine is 35.5. It is around 48.5. 48.5. Empirical molecular formula is equal to n into empirical formula. N value is 2 and molecular formula is CH2Cl. So divide, multiply these elements by 2. That is C2H4Cl. Thanks for watching.